Today, I am going to give you guys a little tutorial of how to record the screen of your iPhone or your iPad or any iOS device into a video file. That is coming up. Hey guys, my name is Tim Schmoyer and it's Thursday, time for some YouTube Q&A. Paul Turner asks this. How are you recording from your iPad? Great question, Paul. I do this on my videos here on Video Creators whenever I'm trying to demonstrate like a new app or show you where certain features are found inside the new YouTube app or something like that. And I also use it when I want to have like kind of a mock whiteboard where I can draw and scribble and kind of draw diagrams and explain what I'm talking about. And the way I do this is actually very simple thanks to the AirPlay feature that's built into iOS. AirPlay lets me display my screen on any device that's connected to an Apple TV. But in my case, I want to display my iPad screen on my computer. And the way I do that is I use a little program called AirServer that lets me display my iOS screen straight on my computer screen. I open up the AirServer program on my computer and then it starts looking for iOS devices that are using AirPlay to kind of share their screens. And then I go to my iOS device, go to AirPlay to share it, and then boom, it just pops up right on my computer screen. Now the trick to capturing the photos is actually just to use a screen capture program. If you are on Mac, QuickTime has screen capture built right in, screen recording. I personally prefer to use iShow UHD, which I will link up in the description text for you guys below this video. And I prefer it because it uses way less CPU power. So it actually has like a lot smoother video recording of my screen. It has way more options as far as recording audio and other things. And it's very easy for me to select which window I want to record. And in this case, it's the AirServer window and record only that rather than like my entire desktop. At that point, I simply hit record on my screen capture program and I do whatever I need to do on my iOS device. And then when I'm done, I end recording and boom, I have a video file of my iPad or iPhone right on my computer for me to use to edit into one of my other videos or just upload as a demonstration or do whatever I'd like with. I will link up to AirServer and iShow UHD both in the description text below if you want a link to go directly to those apps and find out more about them. And if any of you guys make videos of apps or screen capture, mobile gaming or anything like that, I watch a lot of Clash of Clans, so that's always fun. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments below about how you use this and what you capture and what tools you use to capture the video from your iOS devices. And for you guys on Android, if you have some great tutorials about this, please link up below to those as well. If you guys are looking for something that has to do with Android, look for the links down there that people are sharing. If this is your first time here, I'd love to have you subscribe. Every Tuesday, we take a look at online video news and talk about the implications as for us as creators. On Wednesdays, to give you guys some YouTube tips and ideas and suggestions and advice. And then on Thursdays, we do just like what you saw here today, and I answer a question from one of you guys because I really want to help you guys. I believe that some of you have messages that can really change the world, influence people's lives, and make this world a better place. And I want to do all that I can to help you and support you in growing your audience and building your YouTube channel and spreading your message so that as many people can hear your message as possible. So thank you for letting me be a part of that. Subscribe, and I will see you guys again next week. Bye.